Hi everyone, today we're going to take a closer look at a very familiar flower you may see popping up in your yard or neighborhood park. Today we're going to take a closer look at dandelions. Dandelions are sometimes the first flowers we see in spring. You may even have seen dandelions blooming in the middle of winter. You can recognize a dandelion by their yellow flowers and the smooth green leaves that look like they have pointed teeth on the sides. Dandelions get their name from the shape of their leaves because they are pointed like the teeth of a lion. You may even find dandelions that look a couple of different ways. See the bright yellow flowers here? You may see them in this flower stage. When they have these the little seeds here that we can see all over the table that are moving around in the wind, this is more of the seed stage. So these are each of the individual seeds. And that gives our dandelion seed head kind of a fluffy white cotton appearance. Then we also see the dandelions that haven't quite opened up yet. This is the bud of the dandelion. So we'll open up into the flower. And then once the flower is pollinated, it will create the seeds here. Dandelions are also similar to several other types of plants. One in particular that I find a lot in my yard that looks a lot like a dandelion. The leaves are similar and the flowers are similar, but they're not entirely the same. Is something called a fuzzy cat's ear plant. So when we look at these two leaves, can you see any similarities or any differences? So here's our dandelion. And remember, it has the pointed teeth on the sides. And our dandelion's also smooth. But over here, like the name says, the fuzzy cat's ear has fine little hairs all over the surface of the leaves that give it a nice kind of fuzzy, soft feeling. And we notice that on the sides, they're more rounded rather than pointed. So even though these guys look a lot like dandelions, if you look closely, they're not dandelions at all. They're something different. Like most plants, dandelions grow from seeds. Seeds come in many different shapes, sizes, and colors. Lots of animals love to eat seeds, including humans. You can find all kinds of edible seeds in your kitchen. For example, we have some beans, rice, peanuts, coffee, and even chocolate comes from seeds. So these are my chocolate seeds, better known as cocoa or cacao beans. And while these don't look like chocolate right now, they do smell like chocolate. I really wish you guys were able to smell these because they smell like dark chocolate or like baking cocoa that you might find in your kitchen. So these seeds, the cacao beans, actually come from a really cool looking fruit. Looks like this. So they're kind of yellow and they almost look like a little yellow football. And you can see all the seeds inside here once it's been split open. Now I said these don't actually taste like chocolate, and that's very true. So these seeds are very bitter right now. All these seeds that we have here in front of us actually would need to be cooked in some way before we want to eat them. If you try to eat rice or beans that haven't been cooked, they're very hard and really going to hurt your teeth. And so for us to actually get the chocolate that we're familiar with, we'd need to roast these beans and then grind these beans into a powder like the cocoa powder you have in your kitchen and mix them with really tasty things like sugar and milk and butter before we get our chocolate bars that we all love to eat. When we observe seeds like rice or beans that we buy in the grocery store, we can see that they're not growing. When a seed is not growing, we say that it is dormant. Dormant means the seed is not actively growing. It's like it's sleeping or waiting for the right growing conditions. When a seed is dormant, it's protected by a tough outer jacket called a seed coat. Seeds can lie dormant for months and even years until they find the right growing conditions. So what do seeds need? Seeds need soil, sunlight, air, and water to grow. When the seed finds the right conditions, it will begin to sprout or germinate. Once a seed begins to germinate, a tiny root will begin to grow downwards into the soil, and a tiny shoot will begin to grow upwards towards the sun. Roots grow down into the soil to hold the plant in place and draw up water and minerals from the soil. The stem of the plant, give support to the leaves and the flowers of our plant, and transports water from the roots up to the rest of the other parts of the plant. The leaves absorb the light and gases from our atmosphere to enable the plant to make its own food. In the springtime, we begin to see flowers blooming on our plants. We may even still have some right now that have what we call buds, which will open into our flowers later. The flowers are the part of the plant that create the seeds. Looking back at our dandelion, the head of the dandelion is actually made up of many tiny flowers. If you find a dandelion, use a magnifying glass to look closely at the tiny flowers that make up the head. Each one of these flowers will turn into a seed. To create seeds, pollinator animals like bees, butterflies, wasps, ants, birds, and bats will visit many different flowers to exchange pollen from one flower to another. Did you know that a single dandelion head can produce 50 to 100 seeds? And over the course of a year, a dandelion plant can have multiple flowers and produce around 15,000 seeds. Dandelion seeds are carried by the wind and will travel to new places to grow new dandelion plants. Seeds can also be dispersed or spread by water, animals, and people. Many people don't like to see dandelions growing in their yards, but dandelions are a source of food for many types of animals. Dandelions are a good source of pollen and nectar for our pollinators, and the seeds and leaves are also eaten by deer, rabbits, mice, and birds. So to end our lesson on dandelions, we have a quick craft that you can do where we're gonna actually be creating the picture of a dandelion in the seed stage where the head looks white and fluffy with all those wispy seeds. So we have a couple of materials here. Hopefully these are things that you probably already have around the house. But if you don't have some of these exactly, you can always improvise and use what you do have. So, but actually what I'm gonna be using today, I have some white paint, I have some green paint, I have a piece of construction paper here. If you want something other than white, if you can, because we are gonna be painting the white seeds on here, so I have some nice blue paintbrush, and then I have some Q-tips or cotton swabs. We'll also be using these. I said, if you don't have some of these, that's okay. You can improvise with what you do have at home. You can even do this activity with markers if you want. It's no problem at all. So we're gonna be painting our dandelion, and we get to use these Q-tips that are gonna give us some fun texture. And here's kind of what our finished product is gonna look like. So it's gonna have all these little dandelion seeds here, and we have at the bottom, we have our kind of leaves that look like the tooth of the dandelion. So that's what we're going to be painting today. So let's get started. So I like to start my painting with a little bit of grass just along the bottom here. And grass is all different sizes and shapes, and so it doesn't have to be anything exact. We'll start making some wispy grass along the bottom. And then we'll paint our dandelion growing out of the rest of this. So we painted our stem. Now we're gonna start to add our leaves. Remember that our dandelion leaves are smooth and they have these pointed, almost like lion's teeth coming off the side. So we'll put a little bit of those on our leaves too. So they also look kind of pointy, kind of like lion's teeth. And you can add in as much detail as you want. You know, they kind of have a point at the end. We'll add in a few leaves around the bottom of our dandelion stem. Kind of like a triangle at the top. So now we're actually gonna add the seed head onto our dandelion stem. Now we have the stem, we have the leaves, we have our grass down at the bottom. And you can do this a couple different ways. One way that I thought was fun to get the texture is by taking our cotton swabs. And you can use them to make polka dots one at a time, or what I found was really fun is to kind of get several together and actually use a rubber band. Put them together like this, and so they almost kind of become like sort of like a paintbrush, and they're gonna make multiple polka dots at one time. So we can dab it in our white paint. And our dandelion heads are kind of circular, So we'll try and make it circular. So see how it makes several different polka dots at one time. We can kind of go around in a circle, and it'll give our dandelion that sort of fluffy look. And right now it looks a little goopy, but it'll dry. Couple around the edges. And if you don't have cotton swabs, you know what also works really well is just using your fingers. You can dip in and you can use your fingers to make as many dots as you need. And even just your fingers with a little bit of paint will give the dandelion a really cool texture because your fingerprints are in there and they're giving it a little bit of texture. So I think that I'm happy with my dandelion now, but we can always add to it. We could add the sun, we could add clouds, we could add so much more to our picture, we could add insects in the grass. I'll leave that part up to you. And now we have finished up our dandelion painting here. Thanks for joining us again for another edition of our Backyard Science videos. We hope you learned a little about dandelions, had some fun, you'll go out and explore and find some dandelions and other cool discoveries in your own backyard. We'll see you again soon.